The state election campaign has been turned on its head with the Premier's extraordinary revelation this afternoon that he wore a Nazi uniform to his 21st birthday party. Dominic Perrottet says he is truly sorry for his actions as rumours swirl about the existence of a damaging photo from the event. Our state political reporter Lachlan Kennedy was there during the shock announcement and he has this report.
Revealing a shame he's carried for nearly two decades.
When I was 21, at my 21st fancy dress party, I wore a Nazi uniform. I'm deeply ashamed of what I did, and I'm truly sorry for the hurt and the pain that this will cause people right across our state.
Dominic Perrottet coming clean after a cabinet colleague raised it with him 2 days ago. He denies it was a threat.
No one was saying that they would say it. I'm just saying I felt the people of New South Wales should hear this from me.
But the Premier can't explain why the public wasn't told sooner. Not in 2021, when he announced a state funeral for Holocaust survivor Eddie Jaku or gave money to the Sydney Jewish Museum. Not last year, when he delivered a speech on combating anti-Semitism.
There is no place for it anywhere in the world, and especially not in New South Wales. It goes against everything our proud, strong, multicultural state stands for.
And not when he called for lifetime bans for football fans who use Nazi symbols.
It's not acceptable. It's not happening in New South Wales at any sporting game or anywhere. So they're not going back. Once they're caught, they're not going back to a game in the state.
The Premier has had ample opportunity.
Maybe I should have. There have been times. There have been times throughout many years where I've thought of speaking about it. As I said, it's been a difficult thing.
We appreciate that the Premier has personally reached out and apologised to myself and the Jewish community this afternoon to express his deep regret and sincere remorse.
Rumours have been swirling that there is a photo. The Premier says he doesn't know if that's true.
I don't have any picture. I'm not aware of that. I'm not aware if one exists.
Regardless, he did it and now must face the consequences.
Well, let's go to Lachlan Kennedy now, who is live for us at State Parliament. Lachlan, it is an extraordinary admission. Did we have any inkling this was coming?
Hugh, nothing concrete. No, as I said in that report, there has been this rumour of a damaging photo for the Liberal Party that's been circulating for a week, mainly pushed by an anonymous Twitter account that reportedly deals with internal Liberal Party gossip that first raised it 10 days ago, but nothing of what we're expecting to see today. Now, we do have these pictures just into the newsroom of the Premier Dominic Perrottet arriving at the New South Wales Jewish Board of Deputies for a meeting, a face-to-face meeting to offer his apologies to that organisation. We also understand he's been on the phone with the RSL and speaking to other stakeholders this afternoon to explain what happened and to offer his apologies to everyone involved. In terms of what actually happened today, the media was summoned to a press conference to deal with issues relating to the economy and a payroll tax promise from Labor, we were told. We got there, there was clearly this nervous energy we saw from the Premier. He then stood up, and it has to be said, in the softest I've ever heard him speak at a press conference, he then made this startling admission. He took questions for about 30 minutes, but Hugh, at the end of it, there are still three large questions that remain unanswered. Who was the cabinet colleague? Hello, sir. Who was the cabinet colleague who called Dominic Perrottet 2 days ago and raised this issue? Is there, in fact, a photo of Dominic Perrottet wearing this uniform in existence? And thirdly, after nearly 12 years in office, why did he wait till today to come clean? It has to be said, this really feels like it's all about damaging the potential, minimising the potential damage ahead of the state election in March. Hugh, an extraordinary day.
Timing very intriguing. Lachlan Kennedy, thank you.